A new partnership will provide vocational education in high-demand fields for Native American students at Riverside's Sherman Indian High School. The partners are Sherman, which is operated by the federal government, the San Manuel Band of Mission Indians, and the Riverside County Office of Education. The new program is being underwritten with a $2.5 million grant by the San Manuel Band, and there is hope it will provide an improved model for preparing young Native Americans for the workforce. Unemployment among Native Americans currently runs about 25%. With carefully selected career path classes provided by the Riverside County Office of Education, the program will be in place on the Sherman campus next fall. Here's a look at the press conference at which this groundbreaking partnership was announced.
The San Manuel Band of Mission Indians, while a small tribe, has both a global and intensely local perspective on what it means to be a citizen. Their ongoing support of education is well chronicled, while much of their effort is less public, yet quite important. Today, Chairman Ramos is a recognized educational and business leader. He serves on boards and foundations, and he is known for getting things done. I've enjoyed observing his work and that of the San Manuel Band of Mission Indians, and I look forward to his counsel. I also ask that you would please join me today in recognizing Mr. James Ramos, Chair of the San Manuel Band of Mission Indians. Thank you.
What we're doing here today by forming a partnership with the Sherman Indian High School, Riverside County Education, and the tribal government shows that by working together, we could form a model that could work throughout the United States, not let alone California, but can work, and shows that we're not just saying this needs to happen. If tribes are in a position where we could actually start to fund these programs, I think this is something that we need to do. Gaming's here today, and it's been successful, and we're gonna fight to maintain that gaming will be here. But one day, it might not be. But what did we do while it was here? What did we do to move Indian people as a whole, not just one tribe over another, but Indian people as a whole, forward? It's by partnerships that we form here today, by supporting Sherman Indian High School, the County of Riverside, and the tribal governments coming together to form a model and committing $2.5 million to go towards technical training for higher education shows that if we all work together, we can make a difference. We can make a difference to our own people. We can make a difference as far as the educational attainment, and we can make a difference once we become those policy makers on those decision-making tables. Thank you.
As the Riverside County Superintendent of Schools, I would like to express my appreciation to the San Manuel Tribal Council Chairman Ramos and the San Manuel Band of Mission Indians for their generous financial commitment to enhance the career opportunities for Native American students. This unique partnership of tribal, federal, and county entities was forged to address the need of Native American students to develop career pathways that will contribute to new employment and business opportunities for students and continued economic development for Native American communities across the country. A forward-thinking program, the career pathway includes an energy and utilities component that includes the popular Green Jobs programs, preparing students in the emerging renewable energy industry. We look forward to this wonderful partnership. Thank you very, very much.
When the students return to Sherman Indian High School for the new school year, some of the classes they take will be a little different. Each student will be participating in at least one of the new career pathways. Those pathways will be the health science and medical technology pathway, hospitality, tourism or recreation pathway, public service pathway, agriculture and natural resources, and our new energy and utilities pathway. These career pathways were chosen to prepare the Sherman Indian High School students for relevant industry-specific jobs that will be available to them when they return home. Students will receive local, state, and national certifications, and we will be working closely with the various tribes to accept these certifications as qualifications for employment. The Riverside County Office of Education and the Sherman Indian High School will work together in this effort to provide high-quality training programs that support academics while giving students real hands-on career training experience. Today, on behalf of the Riverside County Office of Education and the Sherman Indian High School staff and students, I would like to thank Chairman Ramos and the San Manuel Band of Mission Indians for believing in the importance of career technical education by supporting these career pathways with their generous gift.
When you start to see tribal nations and governments, local governments working together, and really to benefit the Indian people, the Indian youth of the future, we stand here united as a model that could work throughout this region, that could work throughout this United States, to start to really address the issues that really face the Indian people. And I think if tribes are in these positions, then we should be able to come forth and make these types of contributions. So we have the ceremonial check that we're gonna present here, or hold it. We'll take a picture. Time Magazine.
This is Svetlana Lazarova in her element. She's teaching her second year Latin class at Palm Springs High School. In fact, Svetlana teaches Latin 1 through 4, and she has been teaching Latin at the school for 15 years.
Mr. Wright, non habes fabulum.
With the support of Ricky Wright, Palm Springs High principal for 13 years, Svetlana has turned this classical language into one of the school's signature courses.
I'm a graduate of Sofia University, classical philology, and I was a teacher of English and Latin in Bulgaria, my native country. No, I learned English before I went to college, but I did not learn Latin until I went to college. English is my second language. Latin is third. Well, before that I spoke Russian as well, so I know a few languages, I suppose.
Latin goes on all day at this school. 150 to 200 Palm Springs High pupils study the subject each year.
You just observed a portion of a second year Latin class, mostly 10th graders. I think they're doing quite well. They're amazing kids, very talented and very focused and very ambitious in a good sense.
Among the Latin scholars will be many of the school's top students who recognize that Latin provides a keystone element in the foundation for such professions as medicine and law.
It gives them an entrance to all Romance languages such as French, Spanish, Italian, Portuguese, Romanian.
But the appeal of these courses is a broad one. Svetlana's classroom is a salon of classical culture, elegance, and learning.
More than anything, it teaches them tolerance and understanding of what has been, what is now, and hopefully helps them to plan in a more patient, more cosmopolitan, if you will, universal way for their future. And this is probably the best that I would like to pass on to my students or teach them to do, and that is to question the past and the present and the future as well.
It is no accident that for 2010, Svetlana Lazarova has been honored as one of the state's 5 outstanding language teachers by the California Language Teachers Association.
Latin is a very, very much alive. It depends on how we look at it and how we teach it and how we would like to utilize it. It was a spoken language many hundreds and thousands of years ago. So people did think, did quarrel, did love one another and expressed all these emotions and thoughts in Latin. And the fact that we have chosen not to use Latin in our modern days does not mean that it cannot be used. I believe that Latin can be spoken because it is a vehicle to express thoughts and ideas and feelings. Hence, I try to teach my students to approach Latin as a living and breathing and screaming and laughing language. And that's how we do it here.
Congratulations, Palm Springs High and Svetlana Lazarova, California Outstanding Language Teacher for 2010.
I'm Jessica Richeri from a junior at Centennial High School, and my project was an autonomous robotic vehicle preventing accidents, saving lives one at a time. And I basically got the idea from this because statistics show that by the year 2020, the population will have doubled and so will the traffic. And since we can't fix the people, the best thing to do is create an intelligent car. And that's what I have done. And the first part of my project, I created a line detection algorithm, which it takes the data from a video, and then by using that, it creates a region of interest, which narrows down the search area. And with that, it finds the lines needed to for the car to stay in between. And it also classifies the lines to see what type of line it is, so then it can find, so it can just stay in its path. And by using those two lines, it creates a trapezoid, and with that trapezoid, it finds the steering angle of the car and also of the center of the lane. And with those two, they're fused together, and they create the steering angle for the car, and then it has the car move within the lane. And also another part of my project is an obstacle detection. And with that, if first it finds the objects in the picture, and then it classifies them depending on the direction and then how fast it's going using the optical flow analysis. And I also have the pattern recognition that it finds the patterns like road signs, and it classifies them, and then it lets you know where they are, so then you can know like what you have to do when you go to the certain signs.
Hello, I'm Christina Gerges, and I conducted a project at the Santa Rosa Plateau on the basalt dependency of the Brodea Santa Rosa. As you can see here, that it's a naturally non-invasive, it occurs naturally to California, and it bloomed here in 2006 when it was discovered. It grows here because the basaltic spread at Santa Rosa Plateau 5 million years ago, and since then it's been growing every year that there has been a sufficient amount of rainfall. I conducted a series of soil analysis at Chris Amrheim's lab at UCR, and we discovered that the Brodea Santa Rosa is dependent on basaltic minerals such as magnesium and iron. And we conducted a series of physical experiments as well, including texture analysis, color, and bulk density. And we discovered that mafic soils in which the Brodea Santa Rosa does grow was naturally denser. We only discovered 7 different specimens in all of Santa Rosa Plateau, which is the only place where it grows. So we consider it an endangered species, and hopefully we can find a way to keep it going so it doesn't go completely extinct.
Try not to reach out, but when I tried to speak out, felt like no one could hear me. Wanted to belong here, but something felt so wrong here, so I prayed I could break away. Take a chance, make a change, and break away.
And welcome to the 14th annual RIMS AVID Senior Recognition Ceremony for the AVID class of 2010. Tonight to celebrate the graduation and the many college acceptances of the AVID graduates of the Riverside County High School's class of 2010.
I sat where you sit some years ago. My parents were immigrant family. My parents, no college education, nor were they very well off. So when I reached high school, I didn't have any educational role models in my family, no parent or relative to tell me what to do or how to do it, or what going to a university or a college campus would be like. No one gave me guidance on what to do when I graduated high school or college. In many respects, I went to a junior college then called Community College today, and actually had that California Master Plan be my lifeline to a very enjoyable future. I was able to go from that community college to a Cal State, and then from there to a UC campus. And from there, I've worked now at many universities around America in research, teaching, and administration. But I believe, thank you. I believe my story is your story, that if you dream big, that if you work hard and clearly you've demonstrated your capability to do that, that you can be and you will be whatever you put your mind to.
I'd like you to look at the vacant seats that are up there. The challenge that we have is to fill them up. Fill them up with AVID students. And that is my charge to the administration, the school districts, and to the teachers and everybody to recruit more students to be involved in AVID. 46 high schools have students that are involved in AVID programs. We need to get all 50 of our high schools involved in AVID. We have 2,030 AVID seniors here tonight. Out of our 2,000 plus AVID seniors, 1,624 have already received college acceptance notices. Wanda Schneider has been the driving force for leading AVID in this county and in the other counties in our region for well over a decade. And this is Wanda's last year. She's retiring. So, I want to thank Wanda for her dedication and commitment to you.
Goodness, I wasn't planning on saying anything about that. I am going to retire. I have been a teacher, a counselor, and an administrator for the past 41 years. The last 28 years of my career, I have had the privilege of working with AVID, and if you think it's been a good program for you, let me tell you, it's been a good program for me. It's probably changed me as an educator as much as it's changed you as students. I have seen probably thousands and thousands of students whose lives have been changed because of the opportunities that have been afforded you through the AVID program, and I am just thrilled that I had the opportunity to work with this program. So, thank you. The Gates Millennium Scholarship. This is a huge scholarship. This scholarship will pay any unmet financial need for these scholarship winners to any college or university of their choice. in the disciplines of education, engineering, library science, math, public health, or the sciences. I don't know if you heard what I said, but they will pay any unmet need that these students have from their first year of undergraduate school through their PhD. That's a lot of money. I am really proud to tell you that we have 7 of those winners from Riverside County here tonight of the Dell Scholarship. And let me tell you a little bit about that scholarship. The Dell Scholarship provides $20,000 to each winner over a period of up to 6 years. Not only do these students receive $20,000, but they also receive technology, resources, and mentoring to make sure that they graduate from college. There were 300 Dell scholarships awarded to AVID students across the nation, and I am really proud to say that 34 of those were awarded in this region.
Scott Lockman, Ramona High School.
Ramona High School is celebrating our 22nd year of AVID, which started with Wanda Snyder's first class of AVID in 1989. Wanda, you have inspired and impacted what you see here tonight. Thank you so much. Ramona seniors, this has truly been an amazing year for Ramona High School. This year we have 113 seniors. The largest senior class in the history of AVID. Some of our acceptances include MIT, Duke University, the Claremont Colleges, Berkeley, UCLA, WPI, and USC, just to name a few. We also had a Gates Scholarship and 2 Dell Scholarship winners. And the total number of acceptances at this time is 395. Congratulations. Collectively, so far, you have also received $1.5 million in financial aid. And I am confident when everything comes in, you will break the $2 million mark. It is my highest honor to present the Ramona AVID class of 2010.
But if you won any scholarship, would you please stand up? Anybody who won any scholarship this year, please stand up.
In a small town, when the rain would fall down, I'd just stare out my window, dreaming of what could be, and if I'd end up happy, I would pray. Trying not to reach out, when I tried to speak out, felt like no one could hear me. Wanting to belong here, something felt so wrong here, so I prayed I could break away. I'll spread my wings and I'll learn how to fly. I'll do what it takes till I touch the sky. And I'll make a wish, take a chance, make a change, and break away. Darkness and into the sun, but I won't forget all the ones that I love. Take a risk, take a chance, make a change, and break away. La da dum da da, la da dum da da, la da dum da 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 da. Wanna feel the warm breeze, sleep under a palm tree, feel the rush of the ocean. Get aboard a fast train, travel on a jet plane, far away, and break away. I'll spread my wings and I'll learn how to fly. I'll do what it takes till I touch the sky. And I'll make a wish, take a chance, make a change, and break away. That I love, I gotta take a risk, take a chance, make a change, and break away. Buildings with 100 floors, dream around revolving doors. Maybe I don't know where they'll take me, but I gotta keep moving on, moving on. Fly away, break away. Take a chance, make a change, and break away. Out of the darkness and into the sun, but I won't forget the place I come from. I gotta take a risk, take a chance, make a change, and break.